Hello, veteran 0121 here. Welcome back. This is another episode of Dragon Quest VII. In the last episode, we defeated the Flame Spirit and obtained the Flame Charm. Now, this gives you a plus 25 to attack power, like I mentioned in the last video. It also will allow you to cast the Blazemore spell when used as an item in battle. Not very good. You'd think, you know, getting something from a flame spirit, like an all-powerful flame spirit or something like that, would give you something like, I don't know, Blazemost, maybe? Not Blazemore, come on. Blazemost, that would be a good reward, man. That would be an outstanding reward. Yes, we do. Alright, thanks, Pam. Been a lot of help to us. But yeah, at this point, we need to head back to Fishbell. Yeah, okay. Alright, so we have to... I don't know... We're gonna have to go through the mountain again, I think, to get to the warp point. Or the Traveler's Gates, as they call them. Became a black belt and she learned Roundhouse. Ooh. Ooh. She can now roundhouse people. So yeah, the game doesn't really tell you what to do next at all. At all. There's like no mention of like where you're supposed to go next or what you're supposed to do next or anything. So yeah, this is one of those weird spots where it's like, can I at least use my return spell? Yeah, it's fuck. I'm gonna have to go all the way out these fucking ruins. I don't have to do that, do I? There's gotta be a better way. I'm not thinking right here. There's got to be a better way. Can't we just go through the, No, we can't. We can't go through that way. Whatever, man. I don't know what's going on. I'm so used to just going out here and just hitting return. I forgot how to navigate this area. Because it's been a while. Whatever, I guess I'll go out the long way. Sorry about that, folks. Shouldn't take too long to get back. Going this direction. Yeah, now that I'm thinking about it, we can't go out the shortcut way because that part is sealed. It's still sealed. The only thing that we've unlocked is the flame gate so far. Sheep Duck. Ducks. I don't know why I like saying that, but I do. Sheep ducks. Probably because it just sounds so fucking stupid. Fucking sheep duck. Yeah, alright. Great, I got a sheep duck in my monster park now. Outstanding. Ship. Oh. Yeah, get out of my way, lady. I don't think so. How would I know, man? I know just as much as you do right about now, buddy. Preemptive strike, huh? You're gonna attack them? Sure. So we're gonna go find out what that ship is all about. Yeah, she's been waiting for this the entire game, hasn't she? All she's ever wanted to do is go on a damn boat. And now the people let her. Let me talk to the chef. Oh, yeah. Alright, let's go. Hopefully we'll find my dad. This ship looks pretty familiar, huh? Why is there fire, like, leading up to the ship here? I don't get it. I don't get the fire. What's up with the fire? Thank you. Hey, we aren't monsters. Oh, you jerk. Yeah. Apparently monsters can't climb ropes, according to this guy. I bet you there's some monsters out there that can climb ropes, to be quite honest with you. I think that's a stupid assumption to be like, oh, well, you know, they're climbing ropes, so they're obviously not monsters then. That doesn't make any sense. Sorry. And given what we know about, like, what monsters like to do in this game, they like to disguise themselves as humans. That's another thing you gotta keep in mind as well. Shark guy, huh? Yeah, Anise and her unborn child. That is very important. Because it's not really, I don't know, it's not really revealed in the game, but I don't know, it's more implied than anything. Similar to Barango. He's got a birthmark on his arm too. How about that? Watercress, huh? Yes, Shark, I consider your unknown child and the future of the Marl de Dragoon. Dream. Oh, grow fine without you. So you already know that he's gonna grow up without you? I guess we must be on board the ship. Yeah, I think so. Talk to the captain. wonder if he's gonna end up throwing us overboard eventually. I guess we'll find out. Frozen for hundreds of years, and then I guess when we got rid of the fire spirit, it must have thawed you guys out, huh? Yes, I have, as a matter of fact. Yes, I am. I am using it right now. It's a very, very nice sword, by the way. Show it to you, buddy. Yep, hundreds of years ago. So they've effectively been in, like, cryo freeze for, like, hundreds of years, I guess. Okay, so we're gonna talk to this guy alone. What is going to happen? Stared at my arm. Why are you having me hold up the sword anyways? I must be what? What, Shark Eye? Tell me, you know something. And what's happening to us? What's going on? What's going on with the sword? Restored the flame to the wind and the earth traveler gates. Awesome. Well, it shouldn't be too hard. I know it's going to be easier than the fucking flame spirit. So we got to bring the Aquagon sword to Rainbow Cove and pray together with the powers of fire, earth, and wind. Rainbow Cove is the same place that we got the rainbow dude, by the way. In case you're still confused on where that is. Okay, thanks for the info. It disappeared. A prophecy, eh? I'm meant to carry out the mission? Oh, wow. I'm sorry, buddy. One is to Astart, home of Vet. The other is a route leading to parts unknown. And laying at the end of Passage of Flames if you're going to disembark these exit from the bow of the ship. Okay, great. Whenever we need to rest, we can talk to that guy. Wow, these are good pirates. Yes, we met the legendary Morrow de Dragon here, I guess. It's kind of a cool name for a pirate organization. I like it. Nope. I can't. What are you talking about? Your parts? Entertaining ladies? What? What are you talking about? Captain hat. More cell fodder. What? You don't know what's going on, Maribel? Come on. You're the one that's always telling me that I don't know what's going on. Now you'd think that I actually know what's going on? Come on. Sea dog. Indeed, you look much like Shark Eye when he was your age, Vet. Yeah. What do you mean? What is she talking about? We're not abandoning reason. It's observable fact that apparently Shark Guy looked like me when I was a kid. But yeah, in case you haven't figured it out, Shark Guy is Vets, or the main character's biological father. And I think what happened was, is Anise, she basically got, her baby got sent to the future and got put in Molly's womb. And that's why in the beginning of the game there was that whole thing with the 4 months, or like whatever, that she was only in the, or I was only in the womb for 5 months or something like that, so I was like born extremely premature. So in actuality what happened was is I got transferred into the womb after like, I don't know, 4 months or something like that. I was probably in my real mom's womb, Anise, for like 4 months, and then I got transferred to Molly's womb, and then for the remaining 5 months, I was in her womb, and then I was born. So that explains the whole being born premature thing that the priest was talking about in the beginning of the game in Fishbell. Alright, we get a pirate shirt, more cell fodder. How am I doing on time here? Still little bit longer, but yeah, this ship has some of the best stuff in the game, man, to buy, to purchase. It's really good. I'll clear on the bow. So I got two dads. I got my biological dad, who's a pirate, and then I got my fishbowl dad. Both are awesome. I mean, these guys are both awesome. No. Not yet. So yeah, this is a very, very large ship. Very, very. And strength seed. And, oh yeah, this cat. This cat has a tiny model. The clue for the cat having the tiny metal, I think, is like you gotta talk to somebody and he'll give you a clue about it. Otherwise, you can do what I just did and without the clue. Why even bother having that in the game? Jeez. Okay, get another blueprint. I mean, those pots they got at this point, they got like 20 gold. It's like, what the fuck is the point, dude? 20 gold? How about 1,000? Something. Okay, yeah, we can't get in there until we get the ultimate key. I don't think there's anything in there anyways, but whatever. Legacy to uphold as well, huh? Okay, I already talked to all these fellows. And that lady. I think. Yeah, I already got all this shit. A big ship. Anyways, that's all for this episode of Dragon Quest VII. In the next episode, I will continue exploring this ship here and buy some new equipment, and then we'll move on with restoring the or getting the help of the elemental spirits. See you next time. Bye-bye.